So now everyone see my slide. Is that right? Okay. So we will start our lectures today. So the content still related to the classification of marine natural compound. Previous lectures you talk about the I talk about the classification based on marine organism, which is sponge, algae, microbe, and tunicates. Each species or animals, they can produce specific type of natural compounds, such as alkaloid, polyketide, or terpenoid. Today, we will focus on chemical structure of each type of natural compounds that come from marine organism. As I mentioned to you previously, compound from marine organism quite different from compound that come from plants that growing on the ground because of the environment that forced them to produce unique structure of secondary metabolite. Normally they have very complex structure compared to compound from plants that quite general. The complexities come from many rings or come from many heteroatoms. Heteroatoms, hetero mean different, right? Not hetero and homogeneous. Usually come together. Homo, it's like same. Hetero, different. Heteroatoms in this case mean atoms that is not carbon, hydrogen. So it is oxygen, sulfur, or any other atoms such as halogen. For example, chlorine atoms, bromine atoms. Those heteroatoms can found very often in compound isolated from marine organism. And it can mix with many class of compounds such as terpenoid, alkaloid, and peptides. For group of compounds, I only select three groups, which is terpenoid, alkaloids, and peptides, which is the most common groups that you can find it show bioactivities in many activities. The compound can divide it in many, many groups now, such as like polyketide, cyclic lactone, carbohydrate, things like that. But I only select three groups only for this class. So I realized that some of you not familiar with the fundamental of organic chemistry. And when I talk in my course, normally I use the key term that chemists feel like it's the general terms that we can use for communication. Like if you come from pharmacology department, you talk about SIP, whatever number, you probably understand directly like what's the function of that SIP protein. Or if you come from like microbiology department, when you talk about species of microbe like Coccus spirulina, rotting bacteria using their scientific names, you probably like have a pictures in your brain automatically. But our friends, some people doesn't have that. So I think everyone should go back and review and get the common key terms in your imaginary. And then when we talk, you can understand like immediately what it's look like and what it's about. For the chemical functions, I hope everyone can hear this word sometime back in your high school or maybe like first years of your undergrad study. Alkane, alkene, alkyne, right? It's a different type of bonds. I mean, hydrocarbon functionalities. Alkane has single bond, alkene double bond, alkyne triple bond. But alkene can call many ways, such as like olefinic compound. So the word olefin come from petroleum industrial. I I try to write using keypad olefin. So it's spelling like this. No? And then aromatic ring or benzene ring, it's look like this. For functional groups, common functional group for chemicals such as like amine and amine. Amine is here containing nitrogen atoms. Here is amine, nitrogen atom only, and amine, nitrogen atoms with carbonyl. So these are the only two functionalities that contain nitrogen. When we talk about amine and amine, it's the sub-functional group that also found in alkaloids because alkaloids contain nitrogen. Alcohol and ether, they are similar because they have oxygen atoms, but alcohol, oxygen connect to hydrogen. Well, when ether, oxygen connect to carbon atoms, both bond. Go back to nitrogen again. Nitrogen can form three bonds around their atoms, while oxygen can form only two bonds around their atoms. That's why it's limit bonding allow atoms. This is because of electronic properties of each atom. Oxygen, carbons can form maximum four bonds. And here is a halide that commonly found in compound fluoride, chloride, bromide, and iodide. One thing that very important is electronegativities. Electronegativities on the periodic tables, it's classified the highest electronegative atoms. First one is fluorine, and then followed by oxygen and nitrogen. That's the top three atoms that has EN, electronegativities of atoms like the highest. Next, sulfide. So the bond between sulfur and oxygen, we call it thiol. Sulfur also common to see under from the compound that produced by marine organism, but not commonly found from phytochemicals. Like phyto, it means plants. Phytochemicals mean compound that come from plants. The bottom line is a compound that contains carbonyl group. Carbonyl is carbon having double bond and connected to oxygen. They can divide it in many types, such as aldehyde, ketone, ester, and carboxylic acid. Aldehyde, the carbonyl group connected with hydrogen atoms, while ketone connected with alkyl group, ester connected with ether linkage like oxygen, and next is alkyl group, and carboxylic acid is carbonyl connected with hydroxyl group, and the last one is amine, carbonyl connected with nitrogen functionalities. So this is a general functionalities that you can find. It's a common functionalities. More fancy you can see such as like epoxide or the name of aromatic ring that contain oxygen or nitrogen. We can talk about this later, case by case, in my lectures. And also for the secondary metabolites, last slide I explained about simple functional groups. We talk about functional group for the compound, or talk about functional group for chemistry reactions, because it's the variation and changing of functional groups. However, for natural compound, natural product chemists likely to call them by using the group name as a secondary metabolite name. So they have many names as well, such as alkaloid. Alkaloid, the key character is nitrogen. So compound that have nitrogens, we can call it alkaloid. Compound that contain phenyl propanoid. Phenyls mean aromatic rings. Propanoids mean three carbon connected together. We can call them phenyl propanoid, similar to terpenoids, but another type. So that's why they call them different names. Polyketide, it's a compound that have many ketone group. Polyketide need to see biosynthetic pathway as well. It should synthesize by acetyl and malonate, acetyl-CoA, malonyl-CoA, these two compounds or starting materials are involved in their biosynthesis pathway. The last one is terpenoid, which is the compound that come from isoprene unit in their biosynthesis pathway. Similar to organism, we need to see them in terms of how they developing. Chemistry also the same. We need to see the compound, how they develop from simple molecule to more complicated molecules. And the development protocol can identify what is the type of each compound. To the classification of marine natural products based on their chemical structure, I will lecture based on review articles of Professor Hugh and his collaborators. He produced the research articles collecting many informations back to 1985 to 2012 about chemical structure and biological activities in statistic way. So this is the two reference that I use in my course. So based on that articles, he explained that marine natural products can divide it into eight groups, which is terpenoid, steroid, alkaloid, ether, polyphenol, sphingolactone, peptides, and like miscellaneous group. I think for terpenoid, alkaloid, ether, polyphenol, peptides, you already hear this word and may have general pictures how the compound look like. For the steroid, if you remember steroid hormone, they have the characters of the molecule by the ring connection. They will have three, six membered rings connected together. And the last ring, which is the fourth ring, it is five membered ring. So this is the system of steroid. Steroid compound normally have the core structure as a steroid system. The new name of chemical compound is sphingolactone. Sphingolactone, you hear the word lactone already. Lactone is cyclic ester. So this compound, they are tricyclic lactone and connected to hydroxymethylbutenolide. And on the left side is the structure of this compound. Sphingolactone, they have three cyclic rings and one ring is lactone. Also, they have butenolide. What is the butenolide? It is the ring here. It's the prefix of chemical names, means four carbon atoms, like methyl, met means one carbon atom, ethyl, two carbon atoms, propyl, three, butyl, four, pentyl, five. Butenolides mean the D ring. They have four carbons and it is cyclic lactone, T, buty, TE, mean alkene. That means it has alkenes in the system. If this compound name changed to buta, butanolide, this D ring will not contain double bond. So this is like the meaning that imply when you see the name. For chemists as I am, I was trained to understand the name of the compound, but we can only understand general name only. The fancy names like curcumin, that's already fancy by its name, I cannot understand what it is. What is it? But citronella is a natural compound found in lemongrass to use as insect repellent. Citronella, the last word LA, นะคะ still don't understand what it is, but it, if it changed to citronella, LAL, that AL may come from like alcohol or aldehyde. Citronella, LA is alcohol. LAL, it's aldehyde. Citronerone, for example, O-N-E means like ketone. So that's the IUPAC system name that help chemists to guess what is the structure that would found in that molecules. So this is in general, we can find these 8 groups in marine natural products. And in statistically, the major group of natural compound found in marine organism, the top one is alkaloids. So it show about 24%. That means in general, compound from marine organism normally contains nitrogen. Nitrogen difficult to find in compound from plants. And the origins of nitrogen come from amino acid. That means metabolism of animals related to amino acid. However, metabolism of plant rarely or difficultly related to amino acid. That's why it not found nitrogen in their secondary metabolite. Second group is terpene or terpenoid. So terpene come from isoprene unit. They also have some specific enzyme to help productions of terpenoid as well. The major group of compound is alkaloid and terpenoid. How about the biological active compound? In statistic summary, you can see the chart on your left side. The gray color, it means inactive compound, and the black color mean bioactive compound. And the line, black line, is the proportion of the compound that show biological activities. So for alkaloids, compounds that show biological activities show a large portion. It's the second group of compound that show biological activities. The first group is peptide. However, total amount of peptide found in marine organism is less than alkaloid. I think because of its stability. Usually peptide very unstable and it's decomposed automatically throughout the isolation process. To isolate peptide, it needs many cautious and specific techniques to isolate them. The most easy and more stable compound is terpenoid. Normally, terpenoid is stable compound and it's easy to isolate compared to polarity. Terpenoid medium polarities because in their structure usually have carbon, hydrogen, no oxygen because terpenoid come from isoprene unit. It's no oxygen in there. So it's more stable and less polarity, easy to isolate. The third group that show biological activity is hydroxybenzene and quinone. I think it's this structure. I told you already that quinone normally produced from microbials. And in ocean, it's a ton of microbials. There almost 98% of animals that scientists have not identified them. So based on, I mean, to connect between compound structure and phylum, you can correlate information into these two criteria as well. For the compound, based on these publications, they divided into six groups, which is terpenoid, alkaloid, aliphatics. Aliphatics mean linear hydrocarbon, steroid, carbohydrates. Carbohydrates mean compound containing saccharide, like glucose, galactose, fructose, arabinose. Arabinose is special sugar found in marine organism and microbial. Arabinose rarely found in natural compound from plants, but from lichens, fungi living in the land can produce arabinose as well. Peptides is the last group. So to link between phylum and group of compound, if you look at porifera is the phylum of sponge. When we say porifera, first word that come out automatically is sponge. It's the characters of this phylum. Sponge has porous body, many pores. So they have a main canal, main big pore along their body, and their body has several layers. Also have some flagella in the internal layers. For porifera, the key component that found in this phylum is terpenoid and alkaloid. It's a major secondary metabolite that sponge can produce. Cnidaria, it's phylum of กับพุนเขาเรียกว่าอะไรนะภาษาอังกฤษภาษาอังกฤษเรียกว่าอะไรคะแมงกะพุนจำได้ไหมนึกไม่ออกนะคะค้างไว้ก่อนมีใครนึกออกบ้างแมงกะพุนอะไรนะคะดารินทิพย
์เ
จลลี่ฟิชโอเคถูกต้อง Sometimes I like the English word just totally blank in my brain. Cnidarine, such as like jellyfish or any animal that have like tentacles or like toxins, toxin gland, gland mean tom in Thai, gland that produce toxin. So major compound is terpenoid. Echinodermata, such as like sea starfish, major compound that they produce is aliphatic and carbohydrates. That means echinodermata normally produce some polysaccharide, like such as chitin. You know chitin, right? Chitin is the polysaccharide found in shrimp shells, เปลือกกุ้ง in Thai, has chitin, and chitin is a type of carbohydrate. Chordata such as like normal fish, tunicate, animal that has spinal cord or nerve system, the major compound is alkaloid. Mollusca such as nudibranch, squid, some shells, major compound is terpenoid. So each phylum provide different type of compound based on their inside biological synthesis or mechanism that they have in each species and in each phylum. So here is a summary. Porifera and chordata is the major sources of alkaloids. Cnidarine and mollusca were the major sources for terpenoid. Echinodermata is the major source for aliphatic and carbohydrates. Today, we will focus on terpenoids. As I mentioned to you, terpenoid is a secondary metabolite involved isoprenes. if you cannot imagine what is the structure of isoprene, you can go back to my like previous slide. It's the five carbon connected together and also have double bond, single bond in the molecule. Isoprene unit is a general unit for biosynthesis pathway of this secondary metabolite. Isoprene has five carbon atoms. So compound in terpenoid can digest into small unit, and each small unit should contain five carbon atoms from isoprene. If it's come from two isoprene unit, it will have 10 carbon atoms, three isoprene unit, 15 carbon atoms. So it multiply by five carbon atoms, like 5, 10, 15, 20, blah, blah, blah. The largest may be like 40 carbon atoms. And in marine terpenoids can divide it into many, many groups. We will go to each group, but the key point to understand them is number of carbon atoms. Monoterpene contain 10 carbon atoms. Sesquiterpene, 15. Diterpene, 20. If I ask you like what kind of, what can you characterize this terpenoid, you need to count number of carbon. Then you can classify them to monoterpene, sesquiterpene, diterpene, sesterterpene, 25, triterpenoid, 30. 40 is tetraterpenes, such as carotenoids. The new name that you may never heard before is meroterpenoids. Mero means partial. This terpenoid is a group of terpenoid that has a partial structure of terpenoid mixed with another group such as alkaloid, carbohydrates, peptide. So it's a mixing between terpenoid and other functional group in one molecule. So this is a general type of terpenoid. In my lectures, I will give specific names that you can characterize subtype of each terpenoid. So we will talk about subtype. For marine terpenoid, it has a unique chemical structure. And as I mentioned to you, 15 carbon is sesquiterpenoid. But subtype of this group, we can call them chemic green. For diterpenoid, they have 20 carbon atom. We can divide it into two subtypes, is chembrane and amphilactam. So this is the name that you need to remember. They have the unique structure. In the exam, maybe I give you a name and then you select what is the structure of the compound that you can classify into each group. For chemic green, the structure, it's look like these two structure. Very unique because six membered ring connect together as the spiral motif, spiral, S-P-R-I-A-L. Because it's like twisting as the X structure like this. It's difficult to see. That's why it's important that we should talk. And chemic green divided into two types, alpha and beta. The difference of these two structures, you can see the difference by looking at this double bond, this olefin, or this alkene functionalities. We can use many words. I mean, if your publications need to explain about chemical structure, there are various words that you can use to explain double bond. So the olefinic structure of the compound from alpha chemic green, it's contain it in the rings that have dimethyl groups. So it's to point to identify alpha and beta. You need to look at six member ring containing two methyl group first and see whether it has double bond inside the ring or outside the ring. If it has double bond inside the ring, we call them alpha chemigreen. If it's outside the ring, you can call it beta chemigreen. So alpha and beta also have many meanings. Alpha sometimes mean under like the bond with the dashed line like this, under the plane. Maybe it explained using alpha. The bond with the bow mean tube in Thai, bow line like this. Sometimes we explain it by beta, ภาษาไทยบนใช่ไหมบอใบไม้ and the B, it has like related sound. So beta sometimes mean above, alpha sometimes means underneath. So this is the meaning. Sometimes it's mean location. Alpha mean location one, beta mean location two. So in this case, alpha and beta, alpha mean underneath, beta mean above. If you change this six-membered ring to the 3D structure like chair form, chair and board, six-membered ring can draw many ways. So this is the flat way to draw. It can draw like 2D structure like this, or draw it as a 3D structure. So once we draw it in the 3D structure, this double bond is underneath somehow, and this double bond is above in the 3D structure. That's why it has alpha and beta prefix. So for chemigreens, two rings, two six-membered rings with connection, alpha and beta, look at six-membered ring containing two methyl group, and see where is double bond. Inside the ring is alpha, outside the ring is beta. For chembrene, first you need to count. Chembrene has 20 carbon and they have three methyl groups, And the location of methyl group, okay, three methyl groups and one propyl substituent. So on my laser pointer is propyl group, one propyl group, three methyl group, and location from propyl group will be 2, 3, 2, 3. So start from propyl group, two carbon away, you will see methyl group. Another three carbon away, see another methyl group. Then three carbon away, another methyl group, and two carbon away, propyl group. So it's 2, 3, 3, and 2. Connection throughout the whole structure to explain substituent around the rings. This is the general structure that you will see in chemigreen. They have many variations for chembrene. They have many variations of substituent. However, propyl and methyl locations are the same. The last group is amphilactan. The key character is three rings fused together. Fused mean they share one bond. Fused, F-U-S-E. So I will update my slide later. I will put some key form. I think I can do it later. Okay. It fused together. Three ring fused together, and to call the name AB is the base, so under, and C on the top. Sometimes it's like turning around. Ring C, the key character is the ring that connected with built-in substituent. So now 16, 15, 17, and 14, this group, they contain this group. They contain four carbon atoms. We call them butyl group. Ring C contain butyl group. So in summary, these three terpenoid, chemigreen has 15 carbon atoms. So it says quis terpenoid. Two rings twist together. Chembrane has 20 carbon atom, diterpenoid, has propyl and methyl connect to 3-3-2. Amphilactan, three rings fused together and one ring should identify, should label as ring C, contain butyl group. So this is a general core structure of this group. And here is some example. If you see type of compound in examination, I expect that you should be able to label them or characterize them where, what is that group? And if you need to identify substituent alpha, beta, you should be able to do it. So here is compound that isolated from sea hare. Sea hare is animal in Mollusca. It looks like nudibranch, but they have different body structure. They doesn't have rhinophore and gill that identical to nudibranch, so it's called sea hare. This animal found in Spain, and that compound show biological activities to suppress human cervix carcinoma or human larynx carcinoma. Cervix in Thai, ปากมดลูกนะคะ. Larynx in Thai is like กล่องหลอดหายใจอย่างเงี้ยค่ะ. ช่วงต้นตรงคอนะคะ. So it's anti-cancer properties. When you look at the structure of compound, chemigreen compound on the top structure, it's a beta chemigreen because it has double bond outside the ring at the ring that contain two methyl groups. This also beta chemigreen. Chemigreen that show in this slide, they are more complex because they contain halogen atoms. In this case is bromine. That's why we mean scientists call them halogenated marine sesquiss terpenoid. Halogenated give you the meaning of containing halogen atoms. The word halogenated, you don't know what it is. But if I change it to brominated, now you can understand. So it's contain bromine. Chlorinated contain chlorine. Iodinated contain iodine. And sometimes they have complex ring structures such as these molecules. So it has four membered rings in the structure. So this come from the combination of double bond to not quite simple. It's rearrangement of the rings and it changed the connection from spiral to fuse. So this is quite a complicated structure, but you classify them in chemigreen because it has 15 carbon atoms and one ring containing two methyl group. and other ring contain one methyl groups. So this is the key characters. But in my examination, I will give only simple one, the one that you can think and classify. Too complicated, it's too difficult. Sometimes it explained by using biological pathway instead of looking at chemical structure. Next, chembrane diterpenoid. It contains 20 carbon atoms. This is example of chembrane that isolated from soft coral from cnidaria. Soft coral also have tentacles. This soft coral found in Okinawa, Japan. And biological activities of compound in this group is anti-cancer toward liver and intestinal carcinoma. When you look at the structure, the common structure is they have cyclic carbon 20 ring system, but the ring size not C20. You can count later what is the size of the rings and how many carbons in the ring. But the key thing is propyl group and methyl group always arrange in the position that I give you the number, 2, 3, 3, 2. That's the key characters of chembrane. Sometimes it has complicated functionality, such as this one, contain epoxide, three-membered ring with oxygen called epoxide, furan ring, F-U-R-A-N, five-membered ring contain oxygen called furan. Or more oxygen come from ester substituent such as acetyl ester or acid group. These come from carbonate ion, carbonate CO3, which is the common anion found in seawater. So this is like why marine compound can have many oxygens from carbonate, from water. Halogen also come from like an ion, sodium chloride, it has chloride, calcium bromide, things like that. It is the natural sources of different functionalities. Next group, amphilactone. Amphilactone has three rings, such as these molecules. And rings that label C usually have butyl group. So the top rings contain butyl group. We can label it as a C, but sometimes molecule rotate around. No, not always the tops. Ring Cs can turn. If you turn, let's talk about compound number 4. If we turn this compound 90 degrees, you can see this ring and this ring on the bottom. But it's not labeled as A and B. It will always label as a C because of the substituent, which is butyl group here. This is the key thing to notice the molecules. This group of compound come from nudibranch, in mollusca. This nudibranch collected from South China in Hainan province. As Achiraya talked to us at the beginning of the course, nudibranch can found in many oceans around the world. So it's all over the places. But nudibranch that grow in different environments can produce different chemicals. This depends on environment that they're living and also the food that nudibranch eat. When they grow and eat different kind of sponge, they can produce different chemicals. And this chemical showing anti-malaria activities. Example of amphilactone, this also isolated from nonibranch. Nonibranch is a source of terpenoid. In here, I would like to explain more in terms of biosynthetic process. In this biosynthetic process, they talk about geranyl pyrophosphate. I want to call it short. The full name quite long, but geranyl pyrophosphate is this molecule. Here is a starting materials of amphilactan, and it needs enzyme named geranyl pyrophosphate. This enzyme only found in marine organism. It's a unique enzyme for the unique animal, such as nonibranch, geranyl phosphate. The structure look like this. What happened in terms of chemistry? First, they have migration of double bond. Migration means moving. From double bond migration, this double bond, the one at laser pointer, move to the next location, become these molecules. Once it's moved in the right position, it can become a driving force for the second chemical reactions, which is cyclization. Second reaction is cyclization, need enzyme named cyclase. Then it can form to 6-membered rings. If no double bond migration, molecules cannot perform cyclizations. This is the control, natural control chemistry. So it need to occur step one first to be able to occur step two. If you doesn't have specific enzyme to do the step one, step two cannot occur. Or if you only have cyclase, the cyclization product will become different. So this is a variation that nature provide to produce different compounds. Right after cyclization, animal can produce different cyclization, such as trans cyclization or cis cyclization. Cis and trans. Trans mean opposite phase, and cis mean the same phase. In here, we can explain by hydrogen bond. For trans cyclization, you can see my laser pointer. Hydrogen bond that form, it form in opposite phase. That's why we calling them trans cyclization. If hydrogen bond in the same phase, in this case, it's top phase. Here we call it cis cyclization. And cyanide group CN from the ocean. In the seawater, it has HCl, cyanic acid, as a mixture in the ocean. Or in animal body, after digestion, it generates some acid. So under the ocean, hydrogen cyanide can generally produce. However, on the land, we cannot observe hydrogen cyanide from plants. In this way, hydrogen cyanide add into double bond to produce a new CN bond. Okay, come back already. at some point my computer just go to sleeping mode. Okay, go back to this slide. So I explain slowly about biosynthesis pathway, how amphilactone produced. So it needs several steps, including double bond migration, cyclization with different enzymes. Cis cyclization or trans cyclization will provide different structure of natural compounds, and also cyanide group, which come from marine environment, can add it to double bond to generate cyanide bond. This is a summary from what I explained. So it's come from cyclization and followed by nitrite addition processes. Next is example of sester terpene. It has carbon 25 atoms. So the structure is vary. So I did not put subtype in this group. If you count number of carbon and it's composed of 25 carbon, you can classify them as sester terpene. And the unique structure of terpenoid from marine organism is normally it's contained butenoli, and this is butenoli. 5-membered ring containing 4 carbon atoms. 4 carbons come from here on my laser pointer, carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, and carbon 4. And it's arranged in cyclic ester system called butenoli. This compound isolated from sponge and show antibiotics, potent inhibitors of this enzyme, phospholipase, molluscicide, it can kill mollusk, and cytotoxicity. Next group, bicyclic sester terpene. So you can see 2 rings in here. And overall, it composed of 25 carbon atoms, also contain butenoli. This compound isolated from this animal, I think it's sponge, because it has major pore and probably has small pore along their body. It show antimicrobial activities. In each slide, I put reference underneath. If you need more information, you can go back and look over. This slide show example of triterpenes contain 30 carbon atoms isolated from sponge located in Hainan, China. We can call them based on name of group of compound. I show you 2 group. This one called malabaricane. So it's called the malabaricane type terpenoid. So it's show ring structure, 3 rings here. 6-membered ring, 6-membered ring, and 5-membered ring. 6-6-5 ring system, which have structure trans, anti-trans. Trans come from here. On the connection of the first 2 rings, 6-6 system, substituent become trans. Add carbon 30 and 5. Next system, from ring number 1 and ring number 3. Position 10 and position 9. These 2 substituent trans together, but they change the way to explain as anti. It's the systematic name. Anti mean opposite. They can do trans, but it's not allowed by IUPAC. The field system, they need to use it as anti and syn. Don't need to care that much, but you need to know the meaning. Trans mean opposite. Anti also mean opposite. and the last connection ค่ะ at ring 2 and ring 3 number 9 and number 8 it also trans so this system called Malabarican next system Isobaramarican the ring system is trans sin trans at the same location from ring 1 and ring 2 field system the connection show trans connection between ring 1 and ring 3 these two substituent same location so we call them cis and last connection ring 2 and ring 3 connection the substitution trans together so this is subtype that I give you as example of diterpene Marabarican or isomarabarican they have ring system differently Marabarican has trans anti trans while isomarabarican show trans sin trans and here is another example in here I want to show you how they call double bond they can give you some symbolic system such as triangle with the number on top these triangles mean double bond and when they have like wavy line like this it mean they not identify it's a mixing together with top and bottom they can switch either go on the top like this or go on the bottom this way and top or bottom will generate system of double bond as cis and trans cis will use abbreviation as c cis mean the same e is trans trans mean opposite so double bond can identify as triangle which they identify here that means double bond at carbon 13 and 14 is C system cis system cis mean big group at the same size in this case this is double bond right on the ring side you have this here First, you identify double bond. To characterize cis or trans, you need to see substituent around them. Let's say here. So around double bond, they have very different substituent. At the same size, first you identify what is the biggest substituent. The biggest can come from number of carbon or come from heteroatoms. For example, this double bond at location 12, they connected to oxygen. So this one is the big substituent compared to number 13, which only have carbon connection. So you mark the big substituent on one side of double bond. Next size, at number 18, this is methyl group CH3. Number 15, it's bigger. So CH2 connected to CH2 and blah, 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 right? So here is the biggest substituent on this side. No. Big substituent stay at the same size. So it's become cis double bond. So you should be able to identify cis and trans. So try one more time. I will delete everything, but we look at another double bond, such as double bond from 15 and 17 here. This one, 15, 17. look at 15 size first. On this size, oops. Here it's, sorry, I would put it bigger. Hydrogen, right? And here is carbon substituent. So which one bigger? Hydrogen or alkyl? Alkyl bigger, right? So here is the biggest substituent. On another side, in here, this is hydrogen. Same strategy, you have hydrogen and alkyl group. Alkyl is the biggest. So the big size substituent opposite to each other. So this is trans olefin. If you label this double bond, you will do triangle 15. 15. In parentheses, 17 equal to which alphabet you will use, E or Z? E, okay, E mean trans, so equal to E. Okay, easy, right? So if you know strategy, how to think, it will be easy to do it. Okay, next. This I would like to explain about biosynthesis transformation. It's a unique transformation because it occurs by two organisms live together. No? Previously, stellatin B produced by sponge here, this sponge. And this sponge living with another sponge. They live together, so they share secondary metabolite together. Once they share secondary metabolites, one metabolite was used as a starting materials to another. So the first sponge has stellatin B, second sponge has geodin A. And stellatin B and geodin A can combine together by three-step chemistry. The first step is hydroxylation. Hydroxylations occur here by addition of hydroxyl group that come from oceans, minerals. Once it add hydroxyl group, this position changing location of double bond at position 13 contain OH group, hydroxyl group, and position 18 already have double bond. And this system, cis olefin, di cis olefin, is a good starting materials to perform Diels Alder cyclization. You can look back what is Diels Alder. What need for Diels Alder is this system, cis-diene and one olefin. So they need three olefins to cyclize together and become new six-membered ring here. After this other cyclization, you will have new six-membered ring and it's become a new compound. After that, step three is light-induced isomerization. The isomerization is the reason of changing configuration of double bond, whether it's cis or trans. So here's like the explanation in terms of chemical reaction, why variation of structure come from. So variation of structure can come from rearrangement of double bond, addition of hydroxyl group, which very easy under the ocean. Cyclization, marine organism, very good in terms of doing cyclization, they have their unique characters, unique qualities to do cyclization. Light induced isomerization, this is a unique in terms of environment induced new chemical variations. So if this sponge growing in the dark location, they cannot do isomerization. However, once they grow up in another location having the light, so they can do isomerization. This is why same sponge growing different location produce different chemical compounds. So if I ask you to name chemical reactions that marine organism can do well, maybe you can give idea what is the reaction names that could occur under the ocean. Next group is steroidal saponin. You know structure of steroid, as I tried to mention at the beginning of my course. Here is steroid. So they contain four rings, six membered ring here, six, 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 and five. So see my laser pointer. Six membered ring, one, two, three, ring fused together. And the last ring on the right side, always five membered rings. So this is steroid. For the saponin, it's come because of this group combined steroid structure and saccharide structure together. They need to combine together to be able to call saponin. And saccharide part, we call them a glycol. แบบ glycan นะคะ glycan เนาะ oh I'm sorry I think it's switching saccharide นะคะ I think I'll check again and confirm to you that's right so I'll change it now so here terpenoid glycoside structure glycoside, it's a sugar, so we call it glycol, correct already. Glycol, here it's not saccharide, it's terpenoid. Terpenoid structure and glycoside structure. Okay, here. Glycoside, นะคะ, called glycol. Terpenoid, called glycol. Okay. Glycosides come from glycan, which is saccharide here.For steroidal saponin, we have subtype, erylosi, nobilosi, formylosi, or socodosi. The difference it come from saccharide. Erylosi come from disaccharides, nobilosi, disaccharide containing galactose arabinose, formylosi.Tetrasaccharide galactose arabinose sucralose also tetrasaccharide นะคะ galactose furanose and arabinose I think formylosi is trisaccharide นะ let me check tetra okay that's correct นะคะ so disaccharide we call erylosi nobilosi trisaccharide นะคะTetrasaccharide, it could be formylosi or sucralosi, depend on each type of saccharide that represent in the molecule. Here is example of steroid saponin. They have steroid called structure here. and saccharide. The group of steroid saponin classified by type of saccharide, disaccharide, trisaccharide, and tetrasaccharide. This type usually show antifungal. Meroterpenoid, I think this is the last group of terpenoid. Mero come from part, partial fragments. That means this group contain partial structure of terpenoid and another partial structure from other groups such as alkaloid, polyketide, and glycoside. So we can divide this group into three groups, three subgroups, called as terpenyl polyketide, terpenyl alkaloid, and terpenyl glycoside. That means the compound contain partial structure of terpenoid and other structure, depend on each subdivision. Meroterpenoid, this name was given by Nobel Prize chemist Sir John Wauchop Comfort. Professor Comfort. His name was used a lot for chemical characterization. He got Nobel Prize because he explained the biosynthesis of cholesterol. And he also construct the pattern to call the structure of compound, such as name of compound like terpenoid, olefin, steroid. He's the one who give the fundamental of structure name and structure classification. Based on his definition, he said that meroterpenoid are a group of terpenoid compound that are connected to other secondary metabolites by using phenyltransferase. So not only say that meroterpenoid has a combination of structures, but saying that their structure need phenyltransferase as the enzyme for biosynthesis pathway. Here is example of meroterpenoid. This slide showing terpenyl polyketide, so it's a terpenoid mixed with polyketide. Polyketide is a compound that contains many ketone groups. In the synthesis pathway, they should have malonyl CoA, acetyl CoA for polyketide. And for terpene, it should have isoprene unit and phenyl transferase. So there are some key starting materials and key enzyme used for synthesize this type of molecules. And these molecules characterized as sesquiterpene. Sesquiterpene, do you remember how many carbon in atoms? 15, it's a 15 carbon in atoms. So chemists call them sesquiterpene derived in sulfatolide A to C. For us, I only expect you to know like sesquiterpene, terpenyl polyketide, or polyketide. That would be enough. And the compound produced by microbials, Aspergillus, isolated from sponge. That means microbial stay in sponge and together can produce this compound. Next example is terpenyl polyketide, isolated from Aspergillus, growing in this marine sea urchin. It looks like in these pictures, you know, sea urchin, mentally, right? And this is a type of sea urchin and Aspergillus grow inside their body. And they can produce a compound named pileotin A and B, pileotin. Look like this. I think it's kind of common common name similar to the compound that Natamon present at the beginning of the course. But her compound isolated from tunicate. So in this way, it contains terpene unit and polyketide. So it has polycarbonyl. And here, it's a unique structure that is a point to notice that it comes from terpenoid. Propyl group here and multi-methyl group here. It adds the information, make you guessing that this compound should come from terpenoid. Double bond, six-membered ring. So once you see propyl group, methyl group, this make you think and guess that this compound should related to isoprene unit. Also, this compound contain nitrogen atom in the molecules. So we can characterize them as alkaloid as well. That's why scientists give the name that these two compounds are pyridinol. Pyridinol means pyridine rings here. Pyridinone, pyrone, says quisterpene. Based on this name, I can guess that this molecule have pyridine ring. Sometimes it contain carbonyl in the ring. That's why it's called pyrone. And it has 15 carbon atoms. That's why it was called sesquiterpene. This is the name that I can guess. I think all chemists can guess, or general student like every one of you can guess information of the structure based on the name. But if you see paleotin B, oxalicin B, no way, you cannot imagine anything further by this name. Next, terpenyl alkaloid. So it's a terpene contain nitrogen atom in the molecules. For example, notoamide. It classified as prenylated diketone piperazine alkaloid. Diketone piperazine is this structure. Here is diketone and six-membered ring with two nitrogen atoms. It's called piperazine. If you don't know this chemical before, don't worry. I will give you more information later on. What you need to know, what you need to memorize. If it's difficult to memorize, I give a choice for you. So only thing that I expect students to understand from this class is minimum knowledge to characterize the molecule. Advanced thing, it's out of my scope. And this compound generated by mollusk. However, mollusk is the host only. The key source to produce the compound is fungus stay in mollusk. This is a common situation. Marine compound normally come from microbials that stay in the host. It could be algae, mollusk, sea urchin, sponge, tunicate, many things. But in general, marine organism growing together as the symbiotic system, symbiotic, S-Y-M-B-I-O-T-I-C, symbiotic, growing together, symbiotic, sorry, S-Y-N. Next compound is called cytoglobosin A. This compound also terpenoid alkaloid growing, found in endofungus that live with the green algae. And this compound show anti-cancer properties. And structure look like this. For the alkaloid, it's easy to identify. Once you see nitrogen in the molecule, you can immediately say that it's alkaloid. But for terpenoid, sometimes it's difficult. What I mentioned to you, the key things to see is like many methyl groups or isopropyl group or propyl group, built isopropyl group or butyl group. This is example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is pentyl group. But it can classify as arrangement from isoprene unit. Methyl group, talk about methyl group. Dimethyl group is a unique characters of terpenoid as well. If you see dimethyl group, this one is like pointing out that it should become terpenoid. If you not see dimethyl group, for example, in this case, what you need to look for is double bond and methyl group. If you have, if it has many double bond, many methyl group, it has the information that, okay, isoprene unit may become their starting materials. Next, terpenyl glycoside, last group in my lectures today. I give you example of pyrimiran diterpene glycoside. So glycoside, this name give you a meaning of saccharide. So compound should contain saccharide. It could be disaccharide or polysaccharide. No? Diterpene is 20 carbon. So this atom, this molecule should compose of 20 carbon atom. And 20 carbon atom is core, glycone part only. We will not count carbon atom from saccharide. Only glycone part. And isopyrimiran is specific name of terpenoid. No need to worry. It looks like some subtype. Only diterpene and glycosaccharide is the name that I expect you to know. Isopyrimiran, talking about this name, it means 3 6-membered ring fused together in this system. There are so many subtypes of terpenoid. This compound produced by fungus that growing together with sea cucumber. This sea cucumber look like carrots. Their body orange color and their tentacle bright green color. Sometimes it's luminous because of the compound that they produce. This sea cucumber found in Japan. And here is the chemical structure showing diterpenoid in here and saccharide. Saccharide also has variation. For terpenoid, the key things that make you guess that this compound should come from terpenoid is methyl group, if they have like multi methyl group or propyl group. So this is give you an idea to guess it should come from terpene, isoprene unit. To confirm whether it's terpenoid or not, the solid answer is looking at biosynthesis pathway. If they use isoprene, so that is the confirmed answer, whether the compound is terpenoid or not. Sometimes compound look similar to terpenoid, but it doesn't use isoprene as a precursor. So it will characterize to other groups, but it's difficult to know. You need to look at biosynthesis pathway. So summary, what you learned today about terpenoid and what you need to memorize is group of terpenoid. So it has some names that I expect you to understand. Chemigreen, chembrain, amphilactan. This is a group of terpene that contain different types of carbon atoms and different types of rings structures. Second group, it's steroid saponin. It's terpenoid that has steroid core structure and contain glycoside. Each name has different glycoside. Erythroside, disaccharide, nobiloside, trisaccharide, formoside, and sucrose. It's tetrasaccharide. And saccharide that found in marine compounds, normally arabinose and galactose. Next group is meroterpenoid, which is terpenoid mixed with other structures such as polyketide, alkaloid, and glycoside. I may give you some name and let you select what is the structure of the compound that match to that name. So that would be all for my lectures today. If you need any question, you can ask me. You can ask in Thai now.